So when you're exploring in different data science tutorials, quite often they talk all about preparing data. And one of the things they'll often talk about is either needing to remove certain columns or to move certain columns into a new data frame. So we're going to look at our Python code and see how Pandas gives us some neat tools to make it easier to do that. So we're still using Pandas data frames. So I'm going to start off by importing that library. And then I'm just going to read a data file in to give us a starting point. So I'm reading in some flight information here. And if you look at the first few rows, you can see all sorts of wonderful data, lots of different columns of information that I might be analyzing. Very typical sort of data file. Now, you might get into a situation here where if you look at this, you'll notice I want to maybe predict the arrival delay, which is how many minutes late a flight is going to be. And because this data set is so complete, it actually has the scheduled arrival time as well as the actual arrival time. Well, it doesn't take a machine learning model to figure out that if you subtract the time a plane actually arrived from when it was supposed to arrive, you can just calculate arrival delay. But if I'm going to try and train a model to predict what time future planes would be landing, it won't know the actual arrival time when I'm asking it to predict the flight that's leaving tomorrow. So I might need to delete that arrival time column. It's unnecessary. It's not going to help with my model training. So you will have situations where you want to delete it. So if I want to remove this arrival time column, fortunately, the Pandas data frame has a feature to help me with that. There is a feature called a method called drop. You tell it which column you want to remove, and you can then say, create me a new data frame without that extra column. So if I do that, this new data frame I create, you'll notice it still has the scheduled arrival time, but the arrival time column is gone. Now, one of the things you may notice here, and this is something to keep in mind when working with Pandas data frames, is it didn't actually modify delay's data frame. It simply created a new data frame without that extra column. If you want to modify the delay's data frame itself, you can do that. Pandas will support it. You specify the value in place equals true. And that means modify the delay's data frame itself. So now the delay's data frame has no longer got that arrival time column. So it's up to you, depending on how you like to work with your code and what you're doing with it, whether you wanted a new one or to modify the existing one. Now, sometimes we have to split up different columns. One of the things that comes up a lot said in data science is this need to sometimes only have the numeric values to do our analysis or only to look at the string values, because you'll discover as you explore data science that there are different techniques for handling string values versus numeric values. So it's not unusual to take your data frame and say, hey, take the values that are more string or qualitative, put them in one place, take the quantitative or numeric values, put them in a different place. So in this case, if we take a look, maybe I want to take all the string type values, what we would call qualitative data, and move that into a separate data frame. Well, to do that, you simply use a data frame query, similar to what Christopher was showing you when we showed you how to do querying a data frame. So we say, let's do a query using loc of our data frame. And we say, which rows do we want? Colon means return all rows. Which columns we want? We simply list the columns we want returned. And then we take that query result and we put it into a new data frame. And presto, we now have our brand new data frame containing just the columns we needed. So there you have it. Python, with the powers of pandas and data frames, gives us lots of clever, simple ways to remove a single column or to move aside or split a data frame into a new data frame.